Marwan, many thanks for making the time to talk to me today. Really excited to have you with us and really looking forward to hearing your insights on the Middle East retail market. First, Mabrouk, congratulations. You've added a lot of interesting brands over the last few months, Decathlon, Fnac, Darty. You've also made some interesting investments such as Voga Closet, and we're really looking forward to see how these develop in the next few months and years. So let's start with the first question. You joined in 2019. You immediately launched a transformation program at Hokair. You were obviously disrupted by COVID-19 and the pandemic. The country went into full lockdown, stores were closed, so on and so forth. We all know the story. But what we're really interested to know is, what did you have to change to adapt in order to address the situation post the pandemic?
I would say the pandemic has definitely been a challenge in so many ways, but at the same time, probably it gave us some time also, an opportunity to run faster with our strategy to implement what we were looking for, which is transforming this company into a lifestyle company. So the additions of the like of the brands that you have mentioned, whether Fnac, Darty, or Decathlon, or even recently a couple of others, or before that, Kiko Cosmetics, has been exactly what we wanted to do pre-pandemic. So what the pandemic actually did is actually accelerated that. And in a way or another, it has reconfirmed that the strategy that we were eyeing was probably, you know, in a way or another, with all modesty, the right one for the business and for the Saudi market in particular.
We've read and we've heard you say so many times, retail is here to stay. It's a beautiful catchphrase, and that's something we truly believe as well and support. Actually, our consumer priorities research confirms this as true, and we actually expect Saudi shoppers to come back to the store very soon. However, they will still retain some of their pandemic habits. How do you, as Hokair, with the different brands you have in your portfolio, adapt to that? And what are you doing to adapt your overall store experience for your shoppers?
First of all, I always look at international players. We believe that anything that takes place in the US or in Europe is going to probably come in this part of the world in the next 5 years. So even today, if you look at it, the major retailers in the world like Inditex are still opening stores. So offline is not going to disappear. What they actually do is that they build better stores and bigger stores, but lesser stores. So it's again an experience thing. I truly believe customers in Saudi Arabia are very much educated now, exposed, understand fashion, understand the trends, and they don't expect anything less than what is out there in the Western world. Not to forget the Saudi Arabia dynamics. It's a very favorable demographics over here. Young, a very young population, very much technology savvy. But again, they love to go shop, sit in the restaurants, see and be seen. It's actually the outing of an average household over here.
Entertainment is a very important topic in Saudi Arabia, as we all know. According to you, how do you think this will evolve in your stores particularly? Do you expect more engagements and interactions with shoppers and customers?
Renovating new stores and introducing technology is key. For example, we've added a brand from Manchester called Public Desire. Public Desire is originally an online-only concept, and we will be opening the first offline store in a couple of months in Riyadh, in Nakheel Mall. And with this store, I would say we are experimenting what we would call an entertaining experience by introducing, virtual reality and other ways of, reflecting an entertaining environment inside the store. So we're moving online into offline and adding to it, I would say, a journey.
Marwan, given the huge changes in retail, who do you think will be the winners and who do you think will be the losers in the next few years?
The losers, I would say, are those who would not be fast in moving into an omni-channel experience. I visit stores a lot. I am continuously in malls, and I can see how a lot of brands have been slow or even have not done anything to offer an omni-channel experience. And these will definitely be suffering in the very near future. Others are also those that will be moving, I would say, very fast into an online-only space. So again, it's the balance that the winners will have. The balance between understanding that offline is there to stay, retail is there to stay. How can I perfect the experience and the journey of my customer? How can I reach out to them through the other media? And how can I offer them the convenience of shopping online, yet providing them with the option to return, refund, click and collect, you know, an experience and deliver fast to I would say their premises. Really, for me, the game is very easy. It's clear. Winners are those who have the best portfolio of brands and are those who can deliver an experience where omnichannel and you know, online, offline are simply seamless. Others who go extremes are going to probably suffer.
So one question on sustainability. It's a topic that's big around the world, and we're starting to hear a bit about this in the Middle East, but still not at same levels as other markets. What's your view on this? And do you think this is something we need to pay more attention to in Saudi and across the Middle East in general?
Yes, in the Middle East, again, it's about customers are becoming more and more, as I said, exposed, and they would expect in the very near future that they will, I would say, attach, or they will feel more, I would say, engaged with a brand or with a company that would provide a more sustainable, I would say, workforce, workspace, environment. One thing for sure is that we have started this journey. On top of that, if we also talk about sustainability, look at the way we have been working hand in hand with the, I would say, with the society over here, by adding also the Saudi nationals, nationalizing. We are the biggest employer of Saudis in the retail industry in Saudi Arabia. We definitely have a lot of steps to take, but the journey has started. And again, I guess this is what customers expect, investors and other stakeholders.
Marwan, thank you very much for your time today. Really appreciated your input. And I'm really looking forward to walking that mall together with you soon once the country opens up again.
Thank you very much, Karl. Again, thank you for the opportunity. These are exciting times. It has been a very challenging year, but we've learned a lot. We have a lot on our plate, really, a lot to do. And I'm, in a way or another, I am excited, and I am lucky to be in the right place at the right time. You know, there's a lot to be done, and I hope we will be at the expectations of the Saudi customer.